I am JVR and Dr. Anamika Ahebar, Associate Professor in the Department of Science and Technology at Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Today I am going to take the lecture on the subject name System Analysis and Design. And today's session is Class and Object Relationships. In this, firstly, UML class diagram relationships, I am explaining here. With example, this UML I have already discussed in my previous videos also. So there are many, in this diagram, UML case time, this is the association means passengers and aeroplanes, association between these two. And this diagram is directed association means aeroplane is directly associated with the passengers. And this is the reflex association. In this airline staffs, this is the reflection association between multiplicity means aeroplane passengers. They are, see here in the star. That's nice. Star, okay. So this aggregation means you see here this small diagonal shape here. So one dot diagonal, star. And this is the composition, means lab books and library. There is a composition between two. So you you should use this shape. Now inheritance means this bank account is inherited by this fixed accounts. So realization means printer setup or the printer. So this is the relationship in UML class diagram. And many people consider this class diagram bit more complicated to build compared with ER. ER means entity relationship diagrams. So most of the time it's because of the inability to understand the different relationships in the class diagram. So this explains how to correctly determine and implement the different class diagrams relationships that are applicable in object oriented modeling. So what are the class diagrams? The class diagrams are the main building blocks in the object oriented modeling. And they are used to show the different objects in a system, their attributes, their operations and the relationships among them. So see in this example, this is a loan account. In this type is string accounting, string data release date, loan account number and this renew and extend. This is a simple class diagram and attributes and operations. In this there are operations also like this renew and extend, okay. In this example, a class called loan account is depicted, and the class is class diagram. Classes in class diagram are represented by boxes that are partitioned into three. This is boxes partitioned into three means this is the name, this is the operations, and this is the functions. Okay, so first is top partition contains the name of the class, and the middle is the class attributes, what are the attributes which are used in this table, and the bottom partition shows the possible operations that are associated with the class. So next come to the relationship in class diagram. There are various, like in the starting I told you about association, direct association, reflection. So in the association there are the passengers and aeroplanes association between them. So association is the broad term that encompasses just about any logical connections or relationships between classes, like passengers and aeroplanes may be linked as above. Next, the direct association is this refers to a directional relationship represented by a line with an arrowhead, and the arrowhead depicts a container contained directional flow. Next come to the reflexive association. In this occurs reflexive association. This occurs when a class may have multiple functions or responsibilities. Like a staff member working in an airport may be a pilot, aviation engineer, a ticket dispatcher, a guard, or a maintenance crew manager, member. And if the maintenance crew member is managed by the aviation engineer, there could be a managed by relationship in two instances of the same class, right? So they are the airline staff in between the connection. Next is the multiplicity. In multiplicity, you see that it is an active logical association when the cardinality of a class in relationship to another is being depicted. Like one flat, any include multiple aeroplanes, while one commercial aeroplane may contain zero to many passengers. This is the notation, zero dot dot star in the diagram means zero to many. You see, this means zero to many. Now come to the aggregation. In this aggregation refers to the formation of a particular class as a result of one class being aggregated or built as a collection. For example, the class library is made up of one or more books among other materials, and in aggregation the contained classes are not strongly dependent on the life cycle of the container. Like example, books will remain so even when the library is dissolved. So to show aggregation is a diagram, draw a line from the parent class to the child class with a diamond shape near the parent. You see here this diamond shape near the parent child. So to show aggregation in a diagram, draw a line from the parent class to the child class with a diamond shape. Okay, so this is the parent one and this is the child one. So this line draws from bottom to top. So next is the composition. Composition, you see here in between the books and library there is a composition. This relationship is very similar to the aggregation relationship, with the only difference is what? Its key purpose of emphasizing the dependence of the contained class of the life cycle of the container. That is, the contained class will be obliterated and when the container class is destroyed. Like a shoulder, back, side pocket will also cease to exist once the shoulder bag is destroyed. Like to show the composition relationship in a UML diagram, use a directional line connecting the two classes with a filled diamond shape. Here I am talking about filled diamond shape adjacent to the container class and the directional arrow to the contained class. This is the solid filled, okay, diagonal box. Now the next is the inheritance generalization. Inheritance refers to a type, means you are inherited something, properties. Like relationships wherein one associated class is a child of another by virtue of assuming the same functionalities of the parent child. In other words, the child class is a specific type of the parent class. To show inheritance in a UML diagram, a solid line from the child class to the parent class is drawn using an unfilled overhang. Now come to the realization. In the realization part, this denotes the implementation of the functionality defined in one class by another class. And to show the relationship in UML, a broken line with an unfilled solid overhead is drawn from the class that defines the functionality of the class that implements the function. Like an example, printing preferences that are set using the printer setup interface are being implemented by the printer. So drawing class diagram using, you can use this Creatly software. So lots of thought the relationship when we built our class diagrammatic tool. So our connectors adjust to the context and show only the most logical relationships when connecting classes. This significantly reduces your chances of making a mistake. Now drawing from scratch can be cumbersome, of course. So you start by using the software by designing this class diagrams. So thank you so much. This is all about today's session, and this session powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.